To edit to the beat in CapCut, you first need some footage, and you want kind of a lot of it with a lot of different shots to make it interesting. And I went to Burning Man in Utah about a week or two ago, and I got some of that footage I'm going to share with you. So hit the link in the description and download it right now so you can follow along. Plus, you got some really, really cool footage to play with. So we're going to jump into CapCut. We hit import. I'm going to navigate to this folder where I have the footage for you, which is right here. And I'm going to not import the folder. I'm just going to import all the footage. And I've labeled this all for you and numbered it to make it really easy. You can do whatever you want. The footage has handles. That means it's longer than what you need. So you can choose the part you want to use and you can shuffle them around. But let me show you what I suggest you do with it. Now, we have the footage here, but we also need some music, and CapCut's got lots of cool music. And if you're at an event like Burning Man, you probably want EDM music, so that's electronic dance music. We'll type EDM. We've got a bunch of options. Let's listen to this first guy. Now, that kind of works. So we're just gonna drag to the timeline. We only want about 10 seconds of footage for our little demonstration here today. So I'm gonna drag my playhead until it's around, 10, 11 seconds. And I'm gonna type the keystroke that I share with you every time to add and edit and delete all that, which is W, bam, it's all gone. And then I'm going to hit Shift Z so that this fills up the timeline. I'm just gonna listen for kind of a good rough ending here. I think I want it there, boom, and then it just ends. So now that I've found the end that I want for this, I'm gonna type W again, bam, hit Shift Z again, it fills up. Now let's start adding some footage, but before we add footage, we're gonna use CapCut magic so you can find the beat. In the old days, you had to either manually add markers, go dun, 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 or just listen or watch and look at the waveforms, but CapCut has magic. You just simply make sure the clip is highlighted and you click on this guy right here. It's a marker with AI on it. The AI is gonna find the beats. Now we've got a couple options. We can choose beats one, which adds on every major beat, and then beats two adds more beats, all the in-betweens. So we're gonna try beats one first, and you can see that we've got about that many markers, but if we hit beats two, we get way more. So depending on what you wanna do, you'll use one or the other. We're gonna go a little bit faster here. Now, one thing to note, before you start adding footages, you don't need to add a new clip at every single beat because then it gets boring and repetitive. So in the beginning, we're not gonna exactly do that. We're gonna jump over here into media. We're gonna start with clip one, made it easy for you. Drag to the timeline, and this is some drone footage, and it looks cool, but and you may have noticed that it had a little jiggle right there, so we for sure don't want to use that, so we're going to trim that off. So to trim this with the track magnet on, I'm going to type the letter Q, so it's going to add and edit, delete that, slide everything over, bam, and let's see if it starts right. Oh, it did it again. So we'll just move a little farther down, and let's go to the end and see if this is good all the way through. Yeah, it's good all the way through. So what I want to do is have this go kind of fast in the beginning and not stop here, but maybe stop on this second beat right here. So to do that, to speed it up, it's super easy in CapCut, we simply make sure the clip is highlighted in the timeline, we click on Video, Speed, and we can either drag this over and it'll speed it up a bunch, or we can, I'll just put it back. So when I click on this little handle here and drag it, notice that instead of trimming the clip, it is actually speeding it up. You can see because we have the time code right here. So I'm just gonna drag it all the way to this marker right here, and it's already snapped to the beat. So it'll start, it'll look like this. Next, we'll do something similar with the next clip because it's going to go faster with this clip and then it's gonna go a little slower with this drone shot here. All I have to do is choose the portion of it that we want to use. So I'm just going to, starting here looks pretty good as it gets closer. I'm just going to type the letter Q, and because we're already snapped to this marker right here, it's gonna be super easy to do. Bam, it's already on the beat. And I'm gonna keep this going at a normal speed, the regular speed, and I'll just trim it by dragging this back to this marker right here. And now we've got this cut right to the beat. It's going fast and then bam, it's a close-up shot. One of the reasons this is kind of easy is because we have snapping enabled. Snapping snaps or jumps the playhead to the nearest edit point or marker. So as you get close to it, it just kind of, boom, it snaps to it. It makes it really easy. And you can turn snapping off if you don't want it to snap by clicking on this guy right here. Look, it looks like somebody's like snapping. That's how you remember. It's also the keystroke and if you ever want to turn it off. But I have it off and on depending on what I'm doing. So let's go to the next shot. Now the next shot, oh, look how long that is. Oh my gosh. But it's a cool shot, it's a sunrise. By the way, notice that with this video, I am telling a little bit of a story. We are flying into the location with all the trailers and all the craziness at Element 11. Then we're jumping in close, and then we're gonna have a sunset, and then we're gonna go to night. So it kind of tells a story. So let's look at this and find the part we wanna use. Now, this is already speed up. It is a time lapse. We're gonna speed it up even more. So I'm gonna see where I want this to end. I want it to end on kind of the brightest point, like right about there. I'm gonna type the letter W to trim it up. And then I'm going to make sure the beginning is good. Oh, I like that with the sun flare right there. And to speed this up, what do? We just did it a second ago. I'm gonna drag it down in the timeline to the first track. And it notice that it snapped into place because snapping's on. I'm gonna hit Shift Z so we can fill the entire timeline. Then I'm gonna jump over to speed, which adds these handles here. Notice that when I click on video, the handles go away. Click on speed, the handles appear. Now I can drag this back and it'll speed it up as much as I need it to, up to 100x to just fill that little space right there in between those markers. I'm gonna zoom in a little bit here by holding down the command key on my Mac or the control key on my PC and using my scroll wheel. And I repeat all this stuff in my videos just so you guys get it down and for people that haven't seen this before. So be patient with me. By the way, I know I speak quickly, and I know some of you don't speak English natively. So one thing you can do is slow down my speech in YouTube by going on that little gear wheel in the bottom right and choosing a speed like 0.75 or 0.5. It'll slow me down. You can also turn on auto captions so you can read what I'm saying, but I'll try to slow it down a little bit because some of you have had a hard time understanding me, I've seen in the comments. So I apologize for that. Okay, next. We want this to kind of look cool and like hit it with a bam when we do the boom. Okay, that did what I wanted it to, but I noticed that there's a beat right here. Listen. So that would be a great place for these fireworks to hit, right? So what can I do? I can either add another clip, or maybe I can just have this clip be longer than one beat. I can have it go for two beats. To do that, we still have speed selected. I'll just drag this little handle out a little farther, and now it's gonna last longer than those other clips, and I can put the fireworks right after it. Now I'm just gonna drag the fireworks here on top just so I can find the portions that I wanna use, and when that beat drops, boom, I want the fireworks to be like exploding at that instant. So I'm just going to find a cool spot. You can find the spot you like. Let's see, where's a good spot? Boom, that gets pretty bright there. Right here it goes, boom, gets really bright. So I'll make that the beginning. I'll make that the end point of this clip. I'll type the letter Q, and I'll just drop it in the timeline. It'll slide it over. And we're not gonna speed this up. It's fireworks. They look fine at normal speed. And I'll just drag this back to here and trim it up. By the way, if you're really serious about YouTube and editing, you should really take my course, Edit with Trev and Master CapCut. In the course, I teach you everything CapCut does in like 2 days, so you can get over that learning curve and get to being creative and starting to grow your channel where you can start maybe monetizing it. I also teach you in section 2 of the course, every step you need to take to get more views and more subscribers. There's like 10 steps, do them with every video, and I promise your channel will grow way faster than it's growing now, and you will get more views and more subscribers. If you don't, I'll give you your money back, so check it out now. Dude, it's a no-brainer. Let's just add one more clip so you can kind of get it down. And this is a drone show. The drone show is really cool, by the way. And we want to find a spot where the camera is kind of a little more stable and not moving around too much, and the colors are cool and changing. So right about there is good. What letter? I'm going to type letter Q. I'm going to drag this to this first time. It'll snap into position. And I'll just drag it back here. And so far we've got this all cut to the beat. We're not gonna do all of these, but you can go ahead and do that on your own with all of these clips I've provided for you. But there is one more thing I need to teach you to do, because the very last clip is Leela peeling off the sticker on the back of her RV. I'm gonna put it up here so it doesn't move around so much. And we actually got this sticker, but at Burning Man, you're not supposed to really be advertising. So we pulled it off before we ever got there. But I'm gonna make it look like she's putting it on. So how do you do that? Well, let's find the beginning. Well, the beginning we found, and we wanna go from like right there, but maybe backwards. So I'm just going to trim it up here by typing the letter W, and I'm going to reverse this clip so it looks like she's putting it on, because right now it looks like she's taking it off. We're gonna make it look like she's putting it on. So to do that, we make sure the clip is highlighted and we click this here, and CapCut will reverse the clip for you. Takes a second to think about it, not long. And we also want it to be the correct duration. I could either turn snapping off, because if I put it down here, it'll just jump over there. Or I could leave it on this track. We'll just leave it on this track right here for now. And what I want to do is have it speed up a little bit. So we're just going to speed up this last clip by clicking on speed. And then we have the handles and we can drag it back to right about there. And the ending will look about like this. I'm going to share with you one more tip, which is for the audio. Now you could turn all of the audio off because it's a lot of random audio, you know, fireworks and kind of background noise and stuff. And you could turn it all off or you could keep it on. I'm going to keep it on because I like it. I feel like it adds a little ambience and with the music, it sounds kind of cool. But if you wanted to turn all of the audio off at once, the way you do that is highlight all of the clips, even if it's all full of clips, we're not going to turn off the music. You jump over to audio and you just slide this volume slider all the way down and you can see that the waveforms go down. And watch as I drag this up, the waveforms go back up just like that. I know I said one more, but I can't help it. I got to show you more stuff. One thing to make this more interesting, like editing is still fun for me, man. One thing to make this more interesting is to kind of, you know, push in or pull out on a clip. And that's really easy to do in CapCut. You just go to the beginning of the clip, you click on video, scale, and position. These are keyframes. You set a keyframe to change a property over time. The properties we want to change are probably just scale and maybe position if we needed to center it. So we've added a keyframe here. This is where we're gonna start zooming in. We're gonna go to the last frame of this clip, not by dragging the playhead. I mean, we could, but we're gonna hit the down arrow to go to the next edit. Then we'll go back one frame. So we're actually on that clip by hitting the left arrow. And now we're just going to scale this up a little bit so that it's kind of zooming in. It adds a little more interest to the video. And with that, it looks more like this. Yeah, it adds a lot more energy, right? There are a bunch more clips that we could add, and notice that when you click on them, they play. We're not going to add those now. You're gonna do it yourselves, but once you do it, you'll get a video that looks something like this. If you're fairly new to editing and you want to learn the very basics of CapCut, I created a video just for you and you can watch it right here, right now.